Hello everybody, this is Little Neenja, and welcome back to another episode of Neenja's Empire. In the last episode, we came up here to the roof of the Nether, and we built, we started work on that ginormous donut farm that you can just see at the very top of the screen. And I've been doing some AFKing in between episodes and collecting gold, and I set up this smeltery so that we can smelt all the golden swords into nuggets, and, well, I've been collecting rotten flesh, quite a bit of it actually. It's now viable to actually trade that stuff with the villagers, and as you can see, 131 levels, ridiculous. But I'm going to start off this episode by, we're going to go up here and finish this. Actually, I need some materials. What I want to do is add in drop chutes on all four sides of the farm. If you can see, there's the spokes up there that we built in the last episode, and I want to set up automated collection systems so that we don't have to go all the way up there and then, you know, wait for 5 minutes and come back down and collect everything on the ground. I mean, it's far. It takes forever to climb up that ladder. So I'm just going to grab a bunch of resources here, and let's see. Minecart, rail, name tag. This is important because I want to catch a zombie pigman and name him and keep him in a minecart, because I noticed when I was AFKing, occasionally, very occasionally, they wouldn't spawn fast enough, and so like they'd all walk off the platform and then they wouldn't be aggro anymore. So I'm just going to go ahead and start work on the drop chutes and be back in a bit. So up here at the top, the one other change that I forgot to mention was I made a snow golem in the overworld, because you can't make them in the Nether, they'll just melt. And I've been collecting snowballs, so now instead of wasting arrows and the life of our bow, we can just grab a snowball and chuck it at a pigman, and he'll get aggro. So now the plan is to remove these spokes all the way back, because thinking about it, these aren't actually necessary. If we just do a little bit there at the edge of the platform, they'll still path towards us and walk off. And that means that rather than spending time with pigmen walking along this pole there, they'll get out of the farm sooner, which will allow for faster breeding time, or not breeding, spawning times. So basically more drops per minute. So I've got to take back all these spokes, and then I've got to go down like 20... what is it, 21 or 22 blocks, I'll probably go like 24 just to be safe, and build platforms at the bottom of each of the four corners, corners of a round farm. Anyway, I'll get to work. And this is basically what the drop chute looks like. I put the bottom half slabs in here so they can't walk off the edge outside of the chute, and then they'll come in here and they'll basically be a wall of trapdoors all the way down, down through the three levels. And the reason there's not just one there is because I notice sometimes the baby pigmen come running off the edge. If they're pathing towards you, they can actually go between like this trapdoor and then the one down on the lair below. So I'll just basically have a solid wall of trapdoors going down through here. And then probably encase the sides as well. I need to put blocks in here like, let's see, like that. And so yeah, that way they fall into 3x1 gap. That way we don't have to use as many hoppers or as big of a landing pad at the bottom. So now I just have to replicate this at 12 different places all the way around the farm, and then we can remove all these spokes here. So I just fell from a high place again and lost 130 levels. Is that a surprise? No. Do we care? Not really. Those levels took like max 45 minutes of AFKing to get. Well, you know, semi-AFKing, like coming just, you know, doing other things and then coming back every 5 minutes and going down and collecting stuff. So yeah, while I'm here, I'm going to collect more wood and stuff, all the resources that I need for the rest of the build, and then we'll get right on with it. So the item collection system is going to take about a stack and a half of hoppers, and I used up all the iron that I had at the moment, and it just wasn't enough, and so I went and did a mini caving session and collected a whole bunch of iron ore, and so I've got to smelt this thing up so that I can make all the hoppers, and that took a bunch of time. It was probably close to an hour, but at long last we are back on the project, and this is basically how it's going to be. So like maybe three chests here and three over here, and then I'll have you know, this landing pad and that one run into these, and then the other two run into the other side. But yeah, this was all the hoppers I had or all the hoppers I had iron for, and I ran out of stone as well. So I've got to go up there and finish. I'm just going to do the tube that goes all the way up, and then I've got to do the other three the same. And what I'll do is just leave like a little slot here, like right here, so that the XP can flow out. I'm not going to do an XP bouncer that, you know, automatically pushes it out here and takes it up to you, because with, like, if you're AFKing, enough XP generates in 5 minutes that you know, it takes you up to around 30 levels, and I mean, you really don't need more than that. It doesn't take long at all to get enough XP. It's not like you actually need 130 levels. So I'm going to do, I gotta finish this tube and then do the other three yet. So the drop chutes are all four in place and they're all hooked up. And by the looks of things, the pigmen pretty much just walk off the edge without being aggro. So that's the storage level, and then you come up here and you can run to the four pillars to get XP. And I might extend this floor eventually. But up here at the top, I caught a pigman and put him in a minecart, and so that way that you know, he'll stay aggro, and we won't ever, you know, come back from AFKing and realize that all the pigmen ran off the farm and there was nobody left to get angry at us. And I named him Hamilton after the squirrel from Over the Hedge. So if we just hit him with one of these, we should see the farm begin to work. And yes, they're dying, looks like. So I'm just going to AFK for a while, and then we should get all the gold we could ever possibly use. That's not good. Why is that guy stuck there? Oh, there he goes. Okay, so yeah, it looks like it could be improved a little bit, but I mean, this farm is it's pretty amazing. So yeah, I'm going to AFK and get a bunch of gold, and then we can go back to the overworld and start work on the wheat farm. But before we go, I just want to mention that I set up a smelter here, and eventually I might do like an item sorting system where it sorts out all the swords, because they're the only items that come through here that aren't stackable. It shouldn't be too hard to build a sorting system, and then auto smelts them. So yeah. I have a whole bunch of gold that I already took back over to the overworld, so we should have plenty now for our wheat farm and beetroot farm. And by a lot of gold, I mean a lot of gold. If we run out of anything golden in the next 50 episodes, I will be speechless. Anyway, so now I've got to actually take some of these down again and go underneath and power them. And then basically how it works is the minecart just runs back and forth all the way along here, and then when it gets to the end here, it's going to drop down a hole, and there will be a track in here that runs over to the other corner over here and comes back up and starts here again. And so I've got to make sure all these rails are powered and then set up the rail that goes underneath that brings the minecart from that corner to this one, and then we go up one layer and do a layer of dirt on top of this. So I encountered a small problem. So above these blocks, above each one of these blocks, there goes a water source block, and I'm not exactly sure how to work around that with the railing, so I might have to do some Googling and see what other people do, because I mean, it's going to be a real chore to try and maneuver the railing around that. I don't think it's possible even. So yeah, I'm just going to look it up and see what I find. Hopefully there's a fix. And as soon as I stopped recording, I remembered that I had seen something similar to this on the server I play on. So basically what it is your trapdoor is at this height right here, and then minecart should be able to run right under there, no problem. Yep, so that's what we're going to do. We've got to do that on all nine spaces where the water goes, and then I've got to actually break out a row here and put in two rows of levers underneath here in order to get the entire pad powered. So I have the track system entirely sorted, and this is the unloader. It's the same one we use in the slime farm, with the hopper here, comparator under that block, running into this block with a torch. And so basically if there's anything in this hopper, this rail turns off. So now let's give it a test and see if it works. The minecart should come along here and land down there and go that way, and it does. All right, so now it should come up on this side, and then go the whole way around the floor, and it does. I had to remove a couple extra blocks here where if wheat lands on them, the hopper won't pick them up, but I mean, it's such a big farm, it's not a big deal. I had to do that in order to get the up ramp to work. Anyway, now I've got to cover this all in dirt and till it, and then we've got to bring a farmer over here from the villager breeder and make sure his inventory is empty, and then we've got to feed him 8 full stacks of seeds so that he never gets anything besides seeds in his inventory. And then we can till all the dirt, and I guess that will basically be the farm done, just walls and a roof. Oh, and by the way, guys, I just found the use for fortune on an axe. So, yeah, seeds. We only had 5 stacks, which isn't near enough. So I have to go out and harvest, well, you know, 3 stacks of seeds. And this axe is actually helping a lot. This grass is dropping seeds like crazy. So the farm is finally ready for the villager, and I have the rail all hooked up, and now we just have to go in here and find a farmer that we don't want, which I think there's actually quite a bunch of those, and get rid of them. That was extremely weird. There's not 2 of them, are there? Okay, well, try not to die. You or you plural, because it's the same word. Yeah, so now what we've got to do is have this guy sit in the farm on the plowed dirt or tilled dirt and have his or plant his carrots. And that is very worried. What the? Well, he's dead. What in the world? I've never seen that. He went through the farmland, and now I can't seem to get up here. Minecraft? Are you okay? Oh boy. Right. Well, I guess we have to get another farmer. Bummer. Well, I got the minecart back, and yes, he died. So apparently minecarts can fly right through farmland. So I made a little landing pad here. So try again, I guess. Take 2. There he comes. Oh look, we can actually keep up with the minecart with the speed too. So we can get there ahead of him, that means. Yeah, hopefully he doesn't glitch through blocks again, because I'm gonna run out of farmers fairly quickly if this keeps happening. No, he's up there. Good. Right, so now I have to make sure he can't get out of here. And close off this gap as well. And break the minecart. There. Now, he should start planting carrots if he has any in his inventory. And then we can, as soon as he stops planting, we can chuck him the 8 stacks of seeds, which I don't have. They're down there. Give him some time to, that is my carrot, give him some time to get used to his surroundings, and then hopefully he'll empty out his inventory so that he can never plant anything but wheat in here. Well, I've been waiting around for probably 10 minutes, and he hasn't planted a thing, which makes me think his inventory is already empty, and it is chucking down rain. So I'm going to go ahead and try to give him, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stacks of seeds. And he consumed them all. Perfect. That means he has nothing but seeds in his inventory. And we can go ahead and plant the rest of them around here. And that's actually literally the whole farm done. Which means, oops, those are carrots. Bad idea. Let's see. Okay, that's seeds. Right. So now when this grows and he plants all this, the wheat will, when he harvests it, the wheat will just lay here and the hopper minecart will come along and pick it up. So now I've got to put a roof on this guy so that nothing kills him. And yeah, and then we just do another identical layer up top for beetroots. So this happened. I didn't foresee this. Before I was even done with the roof, he had pretty much planted the whole thing. And I realized that it took more than 64 seeds, which means that probably, I'm not exactly sure how it works, but I assume that there was an empty slot in his inventory. So I ran and got a bunch more seeds and gave them to him, and to fill his inventory back up so that he wouldn't have any space to pick up the wheat. So I've been AFKing for a while here and letting the wheat grow and the villager harvest. And ladies and gentlemen, we are getting wheat from our farm, which is awesome. So now we can breed up those cows and make bread if we want and all sorts of things. Hay bales for decoration. Right. So now I guess I'll go straight ahead and get started on the beetroot farm, which is going to go right on top of the wheat farm and is actually built identically. So I have been doing some serious work in between clips, and I built the entire beetroot farm. I actually had to walk like 15 minutes off in that direction and find a village that had beetroots in it because the one here didn't have any. And I have plenty of seeds, and I also planted the entire area here. And the reason for that is if we just go down into the wheat farm, it's right around here, and pop up here. Here we go. Right. The reason for that is this farm is not working. And I think that is because this guy, despite my precautions, managed to plant until his, like, the first slot in his inventory ran out of seeds, which means that now the first slot in his inventory is wheat. And because he has wheat, he's not going to go farm more. And because he's not breeding, he's not using it up. So, I mean, he's just going to have that wheat and not farm, which means that unfortunately, yeah, this guy's going to have to go. Let's see here. And wha-cha, cha, get out of here. Oh dear, that's a pain. So now we have to collect a ton more wheat seeds and find another farming villager, and then let's see, and then find the second farming villager, or I guess it would be the third one by now, to go up in the beetroot farm. And that one hopefully should work fine because we have plenty of seeds and they're all planted up there, which means he's not going to have to like empty out his inventory trying to plant the field full of seeds. But yeah, like this is all the wheat we got. And that's how I knew something was wrong because the entire time I was building that farm, that minecart was running, and we should have had like, half a hopper full of wheat or something like that. So yeah, I've got to go and get another villager, empty out his inventory. I'll just make like a temporary farm down there so to make sure he has no carrots in his inventory, and then bring him up here and put him in the farm and get the wheat farm running. And then I've got to do it again with another villager for the beetroot farm. And just as it turned night, I get my farming villager out here. This may not have been the best idea. So basically what I'm going to do is get him into this little opening down here and make sure that he doesn't have any carrots in his inventory before I put him up on the wheat farm. And yeah, so let's see. Push him in here. Close it off so you can't get out. You may not. Bing. Hopefully he gets to planting soon and or just, doesn't have any in. This shouldn't take too long. And then once I know his inventory is empty, I'll feed him. Oh, shucks. I have to go get 8 stacks more of wheat seeds. And then when I know his inventory is empty, I'll feed him wheat seeds and make sure that he picks up 8 stacks, and then we can put him in the wheat farm. And then, hopefully, fingers crossed, it should work the way it was meant to. This guy is really showing off his moves. He can dance better than I can. But he will not get in the minecart. He just does that over and over. I think what he's trying to do actually is get inside there, because as soon as I filled up his inventory, he planted this thing full of wheat. And yeah, I think what he's trying to get inside there to the farmland. So if I can get him in a minecart before he dies, that would be fantastic. So this is what it looks like inside a villager's head. No wonder these guys are so stupid and uncooperative. It's completely empty in here. Good gracious. I finally got the guy in the minecart, which was awesome. He was the most stubborn villager I ever worked with. And then he glitched through the blocks and died promptly. So I am just through with villagers right now. And you guys have already seen this, like, oh, actually I can do this. You guys have already seen this. Probably what, let's just see, 1, 2, 3, 4 times at least now. And so I'm just going to end the episode here, and I'm going to finish this farm and the beetroot farm entirely between now and the next episode. Just do it all off camera. That way I can put some music on the background and just chill out and try and sort this problem, because it is becoming a real problem. But I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if you did, be sure to leave a like, and I will see you in the next one.